Oh, fantastic. You give me a freaking butcher? Also, by the way, we actually get introduced to the butcher in Dead Island. Oh, shit. Wow, this freaking dude's now leaping. The butcher didn't do that. Uh-oh. Well, oh, ow! Okay, it looks like the butcher blocks. Yeah, he's blocking. Oh, dude, this is feeling like a freaking, what's it called? Like a Dark Souls? Like I'm dodging and freaking... Look at it, it's doing nothing. Oh, shit. Miguel! Hi, guys! Too Fly, yo, what's up? Too Gamer, game on! Too Fresh, that's right, bro. Too Gangster, how you doing? Michael! The big boss, Too Cool! MB Cool! The Too Cool Crew! Hey guys, we're back again playing some more Escape Dead Island, and we can continue on where we left off. So, guys, on the last reel, guys, I don't know if you guys know, but we actually were able to go ahead and get two of the out of the three key cards. We got one in the hangar, and we also got one in the big villa, which was the building that was like in the distance that we actually weren't able to go to. But now, since we got ourselves a flashlight, which is fantastic, because unfortunately there were some areas that we weren't able to go into because it was actually dark, and in order for us to go ahead and make our way through those dark areas, we actually needed a flashlight. And lucky for us, we actually did get ourselves a flashlight, so now we're able to go ahead and go into any areas that's had to deal with any dark, you know, darkness and all that stuff. So it's gonna be really easy to go ahead and go into them. Also, we actually were able to go ahead and get introduced to a new zombie type, and that is, of course, is the Siren. So the Siren zombie is basically kind of like the Screamer from Dead Island Riptide. So yeah, but the only difference, it's the same zombie. Only difference is the name is a little bit different. So yeah, but it's still the same zombie. It's just the name is a little bit changed up. So yeah. Also, on the last video too, we actually got ourselves a new axe. And this right here is actually called an Advanced Axe. And as you guys can see, it actually has like a blade on top of the axe head, so which is so freaking awesome. And of course in the back of the axe head. So yeah, so we actually got ourselves a better upgraded axe to go ahead and fight against the zombies. And this is one cool thing I actually like, that even though that we can't actually, you know, customize our, you know, weapons how we did in Dead Island, we're actually gonna be getting ourselves, of course, modded weapons that we actually pick up for the game, because at the beginning, the only weapon we actually start off with was a screwdriver. Then we upgraded to a club. After that, we got the military knife. Then we got the axe, and now we got ourselves, of course, an advanced axe. So I really like it how we're actually picking up some new items along the way, which is so freaking awesome. So yeah. What else did I forget? Trying to figure out anything else. No, I think that's about it. I think we actually already caught up. Oh yeah, now I remember what I forgot. I forgot that we actually went into one of those tunnels. And if you guys don't know, Escape the Lion actually came out with a DLC, and it's actually called the Underground Tunnels. Now, I actually was able to go ahead and go into one of the tunnels. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to go ahead and go into some of them in the beginning because I didn't actually have the flashlight. And of course, right there, you know, the flashlight actually, I really do needed it, and of course I got it. And I was able to go ahead and go into one of the tunnels. And the only thing that I found under the tunnels was basically a medkit. That's about it. I already found was a medkit in one of the tunnels. So I don't think any of the tunnel entrances are connected to each other. I think maybe some of them are basically like secret rooms that we actually get to go ahead and explore, and we might get some cool items in it. So it's gonna be kind of like a secret area that we're gonna be going into, and we've actually seen that in multiple games too, which if you go ahead and go to like a secret area or like a secret door or an underground tunnel or anything like that, you'll be able to go ahead and get like a secret item or like a special item if you go in there and you know, explore it. So yeah, and of course I explored one tunnel, man, I got a medkit. So yeah, but we actually still got two more tunnels to go to, because there was still one next to the marina, and then there's another one in the jungle. And I was about to go to the one in the jungle, but I wanted to go ahead and go to the one that's at the beach, because it was actually the first one that we actually discovered. And then after that, we're going to be going to the helipad, and I want to go in order. Like, I want to go to the one that was in the beach, one next to the marina, and the other one that's in the jungle. But I still need to go ahead and unlock maybe a shortcut to the marina, because unfortunately, I can't go to the marina, even though there is a shortcut to go there. But the problem is that it actually goes into the warehouse, and in the warehouse, there's only one entrance out, and that's actually the way where I went into. So, yeah, but hopefully we'll be able to go ahead and find ourselves another entrance to the marina, so that way we'll be able to go ahead and explore that underground tunnel that we weren't able to go to before. So yeah, so I'm gonna go ahead and go in order. Now, do I think there's only just three? There might be more, I don't know. Like I said, this is actually my first time playing the game, and I wanna see what else are we gonna be uncovering. So yeah, but either way, let's go ahead and continue on, playing some more Escape Dead Island. We actually left off here in this, kind of looks like a cargo area right here, because there's a bunch of boxes and there's a forklift right here. So it looks like we're going to be going to the helipad next to get the final and last key in order for us to go ahead and get the master key. And we have to go ahead and take a elevator to get there. So let's go ahead and do it and see what we can do. Oh, this is a big ass elevator. Oh, that... Why is that radio there? Oh no, I think I might know what this is going to be. This is going to be a holdout area, right? Yeah, this kind of looks like a holdout area. Great, fantastic. I guess they're going to be fighting zombies in here. Dude, because there's no way they would just put a radio here for no reason. Fantastic. Oh! Well, lucky for me, I have a better axe and my pistol, so... I forgot to reload my pistol, too. Okay, well, let's see what we do. I wonder what the next weapon is going to be on the white D-pad. Oh. I refuse to be up.
What else could go wrong?
Oh, something just
fell. Charmaine, don't think this is the right elevator.
That's a zombie. Wait, let me turn on the radio so you'll get distracted. Damn, game, you gonna add zombies in here? Fantastic. But I think the zombies are stupid. I can still kill them though. Another zombie just fell for the ceiling. Achievement! Deadly Arts. Ow! This dude just bit my ass. Oh, I took care of that dude easily. Because our axe is upgraded. Anybody else? I'm making up. Oh, there's another one. Gotcha!
Stick him with the pointy end.
Haha, missed. Oh, I didn't mean to attack that guy, I was attacking this guy. Screw it, I think I just killed it when they fall down. Anybody else? Oh, here goes one. Oh, that's a bouncer. Ow. Oh, we're good. Jesus, man. Of course there will be a holdout. Oh, man. You know what that reminded me of? That reminded me of Dead Space, where we had to go ahead and hold out in that room in order for us to go ahead and get to the next area, man. We had to go ahead and fight against all those animals. Ah. But luckily, we were alive, though. Because we were prepared. Oh, shit.
Kind of fast, freaking infected. Damn.
No arms. Is that another one over here, though? Oh no, it's a bottle. Gotcha!
Yeah, nice. From behind.
Hell yeah. I can do that too.
The virus causes infected cells to coalesce along the spinal cord after the higher cognitive centers in the brain have been necrotized. The host body loses its higher brain functions and physical strength as the body continues to decompose, while the function to move and act is, well, controlled by the virus to function as long as possible.
Damn. Cool information. Dude, I'm starting to like Cliff. Even though he's actually a new character that we're playing as, and he actually isn't basically in any of the other Denali games, I'm starting to actually like this guy. Even though in the beginning, his friends were calling him a douche. Even though, if you kind of look at Cliff, yeah, he does kind of look like, he kind of looks like that. But now, since we're starting to know him, I'm starting to like Cliff right now. Which is kind of sad that we actually don't get to see him in other future. Like in, well, actually, yeah, because there were only like a couple of Dead Island games that came out after Dead Island that were spin-offs, but those right there were kind of like, they were only available like for the PC, I think. There was one that was kind of like a Team Fortress-like game where you basically had to go ahead and fight against multiple zombies. Kind of like Plants vs. Zombies, there was that. And then there was another one that I actually don't remember what's it called. But there's also another one that was actually called Dead Island Retro Revenge. I do have that game, but that way there was kind of like a mini game with a cool retro style to it. But if you look at the lore, there's no lore that's actually attached to the Dead Island, to the Dead Island story. At least with Escape Dead Island, there's actually some lore that's actually canon from the game. Like in the beginning, you know. Because in the beginning of the game, we actually do play as a secret agent guy. And that's actually 2 days before the outbreak starts. And then after that, 6 months later, that's when Cliff, Devin, and Linda, you know, come by. But that's actually 6 months after the outbreak, so the outbreak has already happened and they already know about it. And of course he saw that Linda got bit, so it's only a matter of time that it's gonna be turned to a zombie bit. That'd be really cool if Cliff actually does come back in the future. Hey, I don't know, maybe he might show up and we might get a reference of him in Dead Island 2. So, by the way, I'm excited to go ahead and play Dead Island 2, man, after I get done with this game. It's gonna be really, really fun, man. Helipad! Oh, it's another tunnel! Oh, shit! Dude, I was just talking about that I'll be surprised if there's more tunnels around. And guess what? There is! So it looks like the helipad is over. Wait, is this even? Wait, hold on a second. Let me look at this area. Oh, I think this is the helipad. I think. Yep. Hold on a second. Let me go to this tunnel. Dude, I was not expecting another tunnel to be here. I thought there was only gonna be like, only just those three. But I actually did say there was there. You know, I won't be surprised if there might be more. So, but I wasn't expecting it to be this soon because I just talked about this. How funny is that? Okay, let's see if this tunnel has something good. Unlike the other one, only gave me a medkit. Also, by the way, these tunnels are really, really far. I mean, look at that. Jesus, that is really far. I mean, if I look up, I can't look all the way up. Whatever. Okay, moving on. A bed. Damn, looks like you can't take a picture of anything in here. There is something this way. Pistol ammo? Okay, that's good. Pistol ammo is good. Oh, there's a recording. The water bird. Oh, what the hell is that? Little slugger. Achievement. It kind of looks like a magnum, but with a big ass barrel. Does this replace our pistol? Or... I'm guessing it does replace our pistol. Hmm. No way this is replace our pistol. I think it does. Oh. Okay. No, we got a magnum. Okay, awesome. Kinda sucks, he only has like one bullet in the chamber. But if it does a ton of damage, then hey, I'm not complaining. Even though it's gonna be a hassle when there's like a whole bunch of zombies around. Ugh. But let's just wait and see what happens, dude. Well, I gotta say, this tunnel right here was awesome. They gave me handgun ammo and they gave me a new gun. Sweet. I was not expecting another tunnel to be there. Yeah, okay. Okay. Awesome.
How'd you get up there?
Don't ask, but there's something here I need.
Oh, there's something over here. Cameron's Law.
I have found more allies, or should I say, assets in my endeavor. For they too are corrupt and fail to accept responsibility. They are guilty, but I will not turn down their help. We will all get what we deserve in the end.
Damn. There's some stuff over there that I can't take a picture of yet. Okay. Where is this final key card? Dead body? Uh-oh. Boss battle? Oh, shit. Oh, it's the butcher! Hey! Dude, we're getting a ton of returns in this game. Holy shit. Oh, crap. These critters. Oh, fantastic. You give me a freaking butcher? Also, by the way, we actually get introduced to the butcher in Dead Island. Oh, shit. Wow, this freaking dude's now leaping. The butcher didn't do that. Uh-oh. Oh. Ow! Okay, it looks like the butcher blocks. Yeah, he's blocking. Oh, dude, this is feeling like a freaking... the what's it called, like a Dark Souls, like I'm dodging and freaking look at it's doing nothing. Oh shit. Okay, one. Oh, what am I doing? Why am I ducking? Oh my god, dude. Jesus Christ, this freaking dude stuns me and I can't freaking run. Okay, well, there goes my death. Hey, I was not prepared to fight a butcher. That was probably a bad idea. I probably should have just kept fighting him. Okay. Whoa! Oh my god, that thing is scary. Find the butcher that can leap. Okay, I think I figured out his pattern. Okay, I think I kind of figured out his pattern. When he blocks, he does like a spin thing. Nope. No, well, there we go. God damn it. Headic pistol ammo. Okay, well. Okay, this time we'll do it better this time. Whoa! God damn it. Wow. Awful great start. Jesus Christ, does the butcher do a lot of damage. Careful. Oh! Wait. Oh! I'm not used to the butcher bleeping, dude. Oh my god, you know what? That would be freaking scary if you had that in Dead Island 1. A freaking fly, a butcher that leaps on you, man? That way, dude, would be scary. Okay, well, that was interesting. Jesus Christ, dude. Dude, I don't know if anybody knows, but the first time that we actually do meet the butcher in Dead Island 1 is actually like almost like towards the end of the game, like in the jungle. And that's like the first time we actually get to meet the butcher. And we actually do get to meet another butcher in Dead Island Riptide, but it's like a huge ass butcher. It's kind of like the same height as the freaking thug. And it's actually, I think if I remember, it was called like an ogre. Yeah, that's what it was called. It was actually called an ogre. And Jesus, but dude, that would be so freaking weird. Like, imagine if the leaper, not the leaper, why did I say leaper? What was that from? I don't know where I got that from. Either way, yeah, imagine if the butcher actually did that in Dead Island 1. Like, if he actually leaped on you, that would make the butcher a lot more scarier, man. Holy shit. Well, it took me a couple times to find him, but I think I got it.
I did it. I got the next key card.
Dude, I finally find a doctor's boss. Do you?
Not anymore.
Oh, we're doing this weird shit again. What the?
Is this real?
No, I don't think it's real. I think it's all in your head, Cliff. My dude losing it.
I got all three key cards.
Then use them at the security office back at the airfield. You'll get the master key to the labs.
You don't want it? After all this?
I told you, I'm not here to chase cures.
Why are you here?
I wish I could help you, but we should maintain radio silence from now on.
Wait, whatever.
Okay.
So what about that woman?
She's a certified badass.
Uh-huh.
Badass, that hell yeah.
As long as she's on our side, that is.
Well, she's not on Team Death Breath, that's for sure.
Okay, fine.
Actually, Xian Mei is a badass. Dude, she's freaking survived the Dead Island and Dead Island Riptide, so. There was actually something over here because the pillars were blocking something here. Oh, wow, what do you know? There is something here. Because the pillars blocked the. Hold on a second. They blocked this area, then they blocked the entrance over here. Yeah, they blocked this, and then they blocked something else. Yeah, let me look around. Oh, I think it's this area. Yeah, I think it was this area that he blocked. Even though I don't think he could go here, though. Wonder why the pillars blocked that area. Also. Pictures. Oh, should I take a picture of that butcher? Ah, too late now. His body disappeared. But hey! We actually got to meet the butcher. What do you know? I was not expecting the butcher to make an appearance in this game. I mean, dude, we got the infected, we got the screamer, we got the spitter, even though the spitter is not like the floater, but a little bit like a mini version of the floater. And now we have the butcher. Dude, what? Oh, well, there's something over here. A lab tech was trading some files on Dr. Brandon the other day. Oh, come on, dude. One second. The other day, wish I could report him, but I can't think of any plausible excuse for being in the director's office in the middle of the night. No one must find out about us. Love you, Ben. Ben? Who is Ben? I don't know who Ben is. Ben 10? Actually, Ben 10, one of my favorite cartoons to watch as a kid. I really like it that Ben was able to go ahead and turn into different kind of aliens. Dude, speaking of that, speaking of Ben 10, man, I don't know if you guys, I don't know if you guys ever did this, but if you actually went to Cartoon Network, like CartoonNetwork.com, and actually played some of the games on that, dude, I remember that I would play so much Cartoon Network games in school, man. And it was like in, the most was in middle school and in high school. And I remember I would play that so much when we actually went to, when we went to the computer labs, man. Oh, man. One of my favorite ones was, there was the one that we were able to go ahead and play as Ben 10, and you could be able to play as the multiple aliens. I remember that. And then there was another one that, oh my god, what was it? It was the Codename Kiss, oh my god, I keep it say because it's been a while. The Codename Kids Next Door. Any of you guys remember that cartoon? One of my favorite cartoons too, man. I was so freaking sad that it had to end, man. But one of my favorite cartoons I watched as a kid. But I remember there was actually two awesome games that I played in that. There was that one game that you actually, it was like the ice cream one. That number two was basically the main character, and he had to go ahead and save everybody, and like in the ice cream levels, I remember that. And then there was the other game that was like that trick or treat game, that you basically played as a like an operative, and you basically had to go ahead and turn into different types of Halloween monsters. And the coolest thing is that each Halloween monster actually had its own like different ability. Like if you played as the skeleton will be able to go ahead and open like skeleton doors. If you were like the witch, you'd be able to go ahead and do some spells. If you were like the oh my god, it's been so long since I played that game. I'm trying to remember what the other ones were. There was the one that you were like the sea monster and you were able to go ahead and go underwater. You were a vampire and you were able to go ahead and fly into some barricades. And then there was another one. Oh my god, what was that? I think it was like the werewolf. What would the werewolf do? I don't remember, man. I don't remember, but all I remember is that game was so freaking fun to play. Then there was the one game that was Ed and Eddie. There was that freaking bumper car game. I remember that. There was one that was actually that was Camp Lazlo when you were basically playing dodgeball. Oh my god! Another Ed and Eddie game that was actually in the lunchroom. I remember that one. Dude, there was just so many games that were in the Cartoon Network, man. When you went to CartoonNetwork.com, man, dude. Oh, my God. Just fun memories that I had playing as a kid, dude. Oh, my God, dude. I wonder if the games are still on. Or did they stop doing that? Because it's been so long since I've seen Cartoon Network, man. But I remember those freaking games, man. You know what? I think, you know what, just for the heck of it, let me see if I can find out the name of those games. Okay, hold on a second. I apologize if I'm going on a different route, but hold on a second. Games. KMD. Let's see. I think I found one. Yeah, the Codename Kids Next Door ones. I think it was called The Bad Guys on Ice. I think that was that one. Oh no, there was that other one. Oh no, there were other ones. Yeah, there was the Operation Startup. There was the Operation Graduates. I remember that one. That was when they were, like, you were on different types of planes that you were basically making your way. I remember that one. And then there was, what is the Halloween? Oh, Ice Creamed. That's what it was called. It was Kiss Next Door Ice Cream. That's when you played as number two. and you were actually saving your fellow operatives in the ice cream. That's what it was called. And then there was another one. What is... Here we go. Found it. It was Operation Trick or Treat. That's the game. That is the game, man. Oh my god, dude. So many fun memories that I had of playing the Kids Next Door games. Then there was the... Hold on a second. Let me look up the Ed and Eddie ones. You see, the Ed and Eddie ones... here we go. The Cul-de-Sac Smash. That's one. That's the one that was the bumper car one. Then, what was the other one? Oh yeah, they actually came up with a second one. The Cul-de-Sac, Two Wheels of Fury. That one, I remember that. Oh my god, I just realized. They actually came up with one that was a wrestling one. It was Clash of the Idiots. Dude, I remember this. Dude. And this right here was my favorite too, because this was, because I was a wrestling fan at the time. And I still am, dude. Been, dude, freaking, you were playing as Double D and you were basically doing some wrestling moves on the oh my god, what were the freaking chick's names that were obsessed with Ed and Eddie? The Canker Sisters, that's what their name. You were fighting against the redhead one, and with Double D, I remember that. And, oh my god, what was the other Ed and Eddie game? There was another one. Oh my god. It was the Lunchroom one. Where is it? Lunchroom Wumble! That's what it was called. Lunchroom Wumble. Jesus, dude. This is bringing back so many fond memories. God dang, dude. Okay, sorry about that. I got so freaking sidetracked. I apologize, man. I got so freaking sidetracked because I just heard that name Ben right there, and then it just got me talking about Ben 10, and then I started talking about Cartoon Network. Sorry about that, guys. I just got... Oh, my God. I got so freaking sidetracked, man. But, yeah, guys. Wow. That right there just brought me back memory lane, man. That just took me back to memory lane, dude. Oh my god. You know what? I think maybe after I'm done with this video, I think I'm gonna go ahead and see if those games are still around. Because, dude, that would be so freaking awesome if the games actually came out for consoles. That would be cool. Like, maybe, because those right there were kind of like Flash games, only made for the PC. But that would be so freaking cool if they actually came out for the Game Boy or for the DS. That right there would be so freaking awesome, dude. Headache on the helipad. Jesus Christ, look at this view. Look at this beautiful view, dude. Damn. Oh, God. I just had a huge smile on my face because of what I just talked about, man. Oh. Anybody who grew up with Cartoon Network, man, Nickelodeon... you know, all of the other cartoons, shows that came out, the programs, man. God, man. It was such a fun time to be a kid in the 2000s, in the late 90s, too. And also in the early 2010s, too, man. But, dude, yeah. Oh, man, so many fun memories. Anyways, sorry, I'm still talking about it, dude. Oh, my God. Oh, what's this?
Now, I am exactly where I need to be. Now, it begins.
It has begun! Jesus Christ, after talking a lot, dude, I just need a drink of water. Oh, look, we found, like, a trolley system. I mean, like, one second. Fast travel? I wonder where this takes us. Oh, this took us back to the villa. Oh, that's a nice shortcut. Actually, that way there kind of makes sense because I was wondering why is this big ass hole here. Oh, that's kind of cool. A big ass. Wait. This is actually easy for us because we don't have to go all the way. That's awesome. That is freaking awesome. I didn't actually know there was a shortcut there. That's cool. Too cool, may I add. Also, remember we were here before and freaking giant ass containers fell on us? Oh my god, dude. I'm still thinking about some of the other games I encountered never, dude. Oh my god. But yeah, I remember that one, Clash of the Idiots. That one right there was actually one of my favorites. Because I remember you were able to go ahead and do some cool combos in that. Well, in Eddie, Clash of the Idiots. And also, there was like a special type of move that you can do. That you can actually call it Ed and Eddie to help you out. They basically did kind of like a double clothesline to one of the Canker Systems. Canker Sisters, sorry. I'm trying to remember their names. I know one was named Marie. And the other one was named, I forgot what the other name, is. Oh, man, I forgot their names. Shit, I only know that the one is named Marie. Oh no, May. There's May. May, Marie, and oh my god, what was the other one's name? I'm tempted to look it up. I have to look all the way back into my head to figure out what is the name of the last Kanker Sister. I think it's the one with the blue hair. No, I think Marie was the one with the blue hair. May was the blonde one. And the redhead one was... Crap. I have to look it up. I forgot her freaking name. Hold on a second. Here we go, Kanker Sisters. Let's see, Lee! That's where her name is. So yeah, Lee was the redhead, Marie was the blue-haired one, and May was the blonde one. That's what it was. It was Lee, Marie, and May. That's what it was. Dang it! Oh my god, dude. How the hell? But then again, it's been so long since I've seen that Eddie, man. I mean, the last time that I saw Ed and Eddie was the final episode of Ed and Eddie. And that right there, man. I was so freaking sad that Ed and Eddie had to end, man. But I will never forget the fond memories that I had at Ed and Eddie. I didn't mean to press that, but that was an accident. But either way, let's move on, dude. Whoa! What the heck just happened? Everything just got all dark. Am I supposed to fight these dudes? I think I am. Insta kill! Yeah! I have no idea what the heck is going on, but these guys are getting shocked. Oh crap. Oh yeah, I forgot I had the magnum. Wow, did a good amount of damage to the freaking spitter. The reload speed is actually slow, but no problem. I think I'm supposed to go this way, I think. Honestly, I don't know what the heck's going on. Dude, what the hell is going on, dude? Jesus Christ. Anyways, so now that we have all the three key cards, now we can go ahead and get the master key card. Jesus Christ, man. Things are freaking getting trippy in here. It feels like I'm playing The Evil Within. Because I remember The Evil Within. There was like the, you know, your character would start freaking going insane. That's what it reminds me of, like The Evil Within. I've got a TV eye on you. Freaking puns. The freaking puns, man. Keycard. Lab's main keycard. Oh, I just saw a piece of cake there. Did you guys see that?
I'd like to announce that my daughter, Alexis, will be joining me as the Executive Vice President of Broadcasting. I never thought that I'd be as proud of a child as I am with her. She's smart, driven, a collaborator. She really knows how to get to the heart of a story. Because she keeps going when the going gets tough. Not like my son, who'd rather spend his time drinking with his friends. I'm lucky that I got a second chance with Alexis.
What were you thinking, Cliff, leading your friends here? You should be where I am.
Oh, that was Cliff's dad.
Feeling better?
I feel great. Two shots of straight moonshine cures anything. You want some? Hey, did Linda... Where's Linda?
She left. Something about drunk man in dorm rooms smelling like ass. So, you into her or what?
Nah, not my type.
I think you're her type.
I'm everyone's type.
Yeah, what a prize.
It's the truth. We're talking A-grade prime rib here. Now name one person who's not into me.
Nope.
And now?
Nothing. Wait, what are you doing? No, no!
And now?
No! Not the chicken hat!
Bop, bop. I thought we were gonna go ahead and get gassed out, dude.
Cliff?
Linda?
How the hell did we end up here? Or could this be a dream? I think this might be a dream. Can't take a picture. Oh shit, it's Linda. Oh, what the?
Cliff! Cliff! Cliff!
What the hell is that?
Wake up, Cliff. Wake up.
It kind of looked like the Hulk. Hey, Steven. Unless that might be the big-ass thing that the freaking... The guy that we played with at in the beginning of the game, I think that might have been that big guy that he was looking like. That guy looked like the Hulk, dude. What's up, Devin?
Where's Linda?
I was gone for like 1 minute.
We have to get her back.
Cliff, she was barely breathing last night. There's no way she's still alive.
No!
You weren't here. You were... Where?
I was finding out what happened here. Found a way into the labs.
Linda's dying, and you're fucking looking for a story?
I was helping her. I was talking to her the whole time
on
the radio.
Starting to fight, not good.
We don't have a radio, Cliff.
Bullshit! There's gotta be a cure in the labs. I can still save her.
Cliff, listen to yourself. Linda's gone. Those things are still out there. Linda wouldn't want us to kill ourselves over some insane theory.
What she wanted was for me to get this story, and I intend to get it.
Don't put this on her. We're here because you needed to save face in front of your dad.
If you can't handle that, fine. You can finally stop following me around like a lost puppy.
You know what? I'm heading down to that marina and getting off this island. You do whatever the fuck you want.
This key to the lab says you're wrong.
This key to the lab says you're wrong.
Oh.
I'm gonna save her. You'll see.
Jesus Christ, man. Now they're starting to fight against each other, dude. Oh, so that's what that container was. It brought us back here to the mountaintop. Huh. Actually, you know what I just thought of now? What Devin just said about him and Linda having a radio. Because I remember when we first got here, there was a radio on this table and Devin and Linda were talking to each other. And Cliff was the only one that was actually talking on the radio. And then after Linda got bit by that bouncer, I remember Devin took her up to the mountaintop while we went to the hangar. And we were actually talking to Linda on the radio, like, the whole time when we were at the hangar and doing those other missions. But now, after what happened right here, freaking Devin said that him and Linda didn't have a radio. So I'm guessing Cliff is actually hearing all this shit and oh my god. It's like Randy Orton. He's hearing voices in his head. They talk to me. They understand. They talk to me. Yeah, I'm thinking Cliff is starting to hear voices in his head. So I'm guessing every single time we hear Linda's voice, that might not be Linda.
Cliff? Can you hear me? I'm alone. I don't know where I am.
Who is this?
It's me. I still have the radio. It's so small, no one knows I have it.
I'm coming for you.
What about Devin?
He can take care of himself.
I don't know about that, Cliff. That's kind of a bad thing to do between you and Devin, man. I mean, come on. You, Devin, and Linda came here. And now you guys are just gonna go ahead and separate? That right there is not a good idea. If you're trying to survive, probably not a good idea to split it up. Especially like in horror movies, man. God, dude. Anybody know how when it comes to the horror movies, anybody decides to go ahead and split it up? Yeah, you know what, guys? This would be a good idea. Let's go ahead and split up and not stick together. Yeah, let's go ahead and do that. Yeah. Oh, it's a zombie. Gotcha!
Stick him with the pointy end.
Oh, look, we're back here again. Geoform Labs. Whoa.
Deep breath, clear mind.
Holy shit. Ah, crap, it's the freaking screamer. Ow. Let's take care of her. Nope. Oh, what the hell did you come for? Ah! Oh, whoa. The freaking zombie turned invisible. Oh, shit. Oh, my God, dude. God damn it. Dude. I'm dying a lot in this game. What the hell? Dude, that zombie turned invisible when he grabbed me all of a sudden. Then after that, another zombie came out of nowhere. Oh, my God. I just got surrounded. I was not expecting to see a freaking screamer split in the same area. Unfortunately, they tag teamed me and I died. No worries, we're prepared. At least we know what we're gonna be facing. God dang it. Yeah!
Never heard me coming.
Gotta hit and equip my pistol. I mean, not my pistol, my magnum. Okay, gotta remember that we're gonna be right here. I'm aiming.
Deep breath, clear mind.
I got it. Oh, damn, knocked his ass down. There we go. Put it dead. Ow! Hi-ya! Hi-ya! God, we love the pinch. Come on, bro. Oop! Yeah! Hi-ya! Nice!
Mind under matter.
Victory! Gotta beat old. Jesus. Damn. Well, at least this time we actually got to kill them. And I didn't die. Damn, dude, I am dying so much in this game. But then again, first time playing the game, so I wasn't expecting that to happen. Kind of like some of the other times when I played, what? Then I Riptide and I died a couple of times in that game. Oh my god, dude. I remember every single time the freaking zombies that have the freaking weapons on them and they basically just toss it at you. Ugh. God. And I remember I got killed by a freaking, I got killed by a freaking infected with a freaking knife. Cause I remember we went into that freaking temple-like area, and then I Riptide and we were defending that area, and I actually had the fence in my hand, and all of a sudden oh shit!
Neutralized.
Sorry, I had to be quiet because I need to stay focused a bit. I easily see me anyway. Yeah, he saw me. Oh, execute, got him. Got his ass. Okay. What was I talking about? Oh yeah, me getting killed by a freaking infected because I was holding the fence to basically block one of the entrances, but then I got killed because I couldn't take the fence down. Okay, into the geoform labs. Oh, I remember this area. Wait. Oh, we're going here, okay.
Surprise.
Oh, there's a freaking spitter over here. Oh, I think somebody saw me. Oh, there's a spitter up there. Oh, I missed. I missed again. Ow. Oh my god. Ah! God damn it. Oh my god, dude. Jesus Christ. It's so freaking hard to get out of there when the freaking zombies grab you, man. Jesus God. I'm doing terrible. I'm doing freaking terrible. Okay, so now we know there's a spitter up there. Am I sure I can wear that spitter right now? I can't believe I missed those two shots. That probably a bad idea. I don't know how I missed that freaking first shot. I was aiming directly at the spitter. Come on, my dude. Oh, did he get down? I think he came down. Oh, execute. I didn't even see that zombie.
How do you like them brains?
Yeah, he did come down. Ow. Ow. You gotta avoid that spit. Oh, one gun. What? Achievement, Thrill Seeker. Come on, explode, barrel explode. Didn't do shit. I'll screw this.
Son of a...
There we go, got him. Jesus Christ, man. The Magnum is not that good when it comes to like the aiming. Is there another spitter? Ow! Oh, wait a minute. There's two spitters up here. Look at that. Dude. How the hell did I miss? Dude, are you kidding me? I'm aiming at him. There we go. Wow, I did not like this Magnum. I kind of missed my pistol, dude. I need a lever axe for this. I don't know how I'm feeling about the Magnum. You guys clearly saw that I aimed directly at that freaking spitter, and two shots I missed. Oh god, zombie.
Sorry. Figured you needed a hand.
Hey, Xion.
Wanted to give you something.
What for?
Yo, this
for
girl is
gave
me all the guns,
to help
my dude.
A friend.
Wait, well, what?
Dude, this girl gave me a pistol, now she's giving me a shotgun.
Where are you going?
Shotgun. Oh my freaking god, dude. And did this, yes, this was the final slot, the shotgun. Dude. My girl, Shiana May, man, she is freaking helping my ass. Man, dude, she is starting to become the MVP of this game. Also, okay. How do we go in here, though? Maybe press the red button? Oh, I see decontamination. Explore the geofarm labs. Oh god. Oh, it's a dude.
Cliff, where are you?
I'm in the labs, and I'm gonna find whatever
gotcha.
They're working on to save you.
You won't be able to figure that out without me. Tell me everything you see.
I was horrified, aghast, when the veil was lifted. I had thought that I, one of few, could see the true face of the fiend. But when I discovered the truth underneath the truth, I saw the beast for what it truly is.
Cool. Is a dead zombie here? Oh! Is that really a cup? We're gonna take a picture of a cup. I guess we are. Lifeblood. Okay. Take a picture of a cup. Also, Did I take a picture of that? I think I forgot to take a picture of the screamer. Whatever. Damn it. Shoot, I don't think I'm gonna have enough time to go ahead and do this part, though. Now, we already hit overtime, so... well, you know what, guys? I think this right here would be a perfect time to go ahead and end the video. But, guys, we actually made some good progress in this game, man. And, I want to apologize that I actually got a little bit sidetracked talking about the Nickelodeon games. The Cartoon Network games, man. Apologize, I got sidetracked about that, man. I just had to go... The name Ben just got me thinking of Ben 10. After that, it led to me talking about Cartoon Network and the games and all that stuff. I apologize for that, but yeah, you know what? It just brought me back down memory lane, and man, dude, that was so freaking fun. And Jesus Christ, dude, Xian Mei is starting to become the MVP of this game. She gave me a freaking pistol. Now she's giving me a freaking a shotgun. This shit is crazy, but I can't wait to see what else is going to be happening once we, progress into the game, dude. But anyways, guys, I'm going to go ahead and end the video right here, and let's see what happens next once we explore the map, once we explore the lab area, escape that island, and see what kind of other new stuff we're going to be, finding out. So yeah, anyways, guys, hope you guys enjoyed. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you guys on the next video. Stay tuned, cool guys. Bye.